Well, ladies and gentlemen, I just got out of the first showing of Thor Ragnarok. And I have to tell you, ladies and gentlemen, this review is going to have some spoilers. So if you don't want to hear these spoilers, if you don't want to have the movie ruined for you in any way, I'm going to give you a countdown of five, and then I'm going to continue. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. If you continue to watch this video, then be prepared for spoilers. First off, I'm going to give you my overall thoughts of the movie, and then I'm going to break down the good, the bad, and the ugly that was contained inside the movie. All I can say is, this is probably the very worst Thor movie of the bunch. And it might be the worst Marvel movie in relation to the MCU. Not only was the story rushed along, but it barely made any sense. The addition of Kate Blanchett and Tessa Thompson didn't do much to make this movie better. And I don't believe it's either of those ladies' fault. In fact, I'm laying the primary problem with this movie on Taika Waititi. He seems to be a very self-centered, narcissistic person to even cast himself as Korg. But in general, this movie was very poorly written. The story makes very little sense. The humor that they try to convey to the people is barely funny. In fact, I think I only laughed twice. Now, I did hear other people in the theater laughing at a few of the jokes. But the humor in itself was very dumbed down. In fact, they dumbed down the entire Thor character. And I don't know if that's because the script was just bad, or if Chris Hemsworth isn't a very good actor, or Taika Waititi, which I'm placing a ton of the blame on, is just a bad director. We begin with the whole thing down in... We're getting into spoiler territory now, folks. Let's hit some of the good parts, because there were a few parts that I did enjoy. The beginning where Thor meets Surtur. Surtur looked great. His voice was lacking, so to speak. It wasn't menacing for one of the most powerful beings to be part of the MCU as of this date. Surtur sounded like a wimp. But that's one of the reoccurring themes in this movie. Is that creatures that should have a menacing voice, a scary voice, or at least a voice to where you would, you know, it fits their physical structure. Korg, Taika Waititi's voice in that one was horrible. The dialogue with Korg, they tried to make him funny. He wasn't funny. Unless you're into that second grade humor. And that's why I'm thinking they've dumbed down Thor. And I don't, it wasn't for the audience, because the Marvel audience, the people who are part of the MCU, who love this ever-expanding universe, they love serious stories like Winter Soldier, Captain America: Civil War, even Spider-Man, which had a lot of funny parts in it, was a very serious story. And I had great hopes for Thor Ragnarok in being a very serious story. We're talking about the end of Asgard. And what we got was a few minutes of Cate Blanchett, your best actress in the entire movie, and you hardly give her any screen time. And when you do, it's barely with Thor. She's off over here, and Thor's off over here on Sakaar. Tom Hiddleston, who's been one of the bright lights as far as the villains in the MCU, this was maybe his worst performance of any movie he was in as it relates to the MCU. I mean, I don't even think they had an actual script. The way the dialogue ran, I mean, they even used jokes that were on some of the YouTube videos when they were teasing this whole Captain America Civil War thing. And Thor was with his buddy in Australia. I have more muscles than you, so that means I have more brains. You guys remember that? They reused that crappy joke in the movie. As well as another joke, actually, that was in those little, I don't know what you want to call them, featurettes, trying to promote Ragnarok long ago, right during the Civil War thing. So beyond that, as we dip a little further into the good, Cate Blanchett was pretty good in the part. I think she brought out all that she could with the weak script it was. The fight scenes between Thor and the Hulk, the fight scene between Thor and the Hulk, although it was okay visually, you never really got into it. You see, I keep trying to find the good, and I can't find much good in this movie. Because once I go, okay, there was a cool fight scene, well, no, it wasn't. The fight scenes between Thor and Hela were not only short, I mean, there was one part where they were just about ready to start fighting. They jumped towards each other to start fighting, and then they cut the scene. Heimdall, another part that the character they just ruined. Here's Heimdall. He lost his voice. He has no deep voice. Remember Heimdall? He had that echoing voice. It was big and deep. Not anymore. Just a regular man Heimdall is now. The Jeff Bloom, you know, the collector. He, it's not a stretch for Jeff Goldblum. Let's just say that. The collector was Jeff Goldblum being himself. It wasn't a stretch. He was no different than he would have been in Jurassic Park or any of the other movies that he starred in. In fact, I found him to be very much like the character that was in, I mean, not the dialogue, but the one that was in the Independence Day that he played. It wasn't a stretch, right? I can't find anything good off the top of my head as I sit back and review this movie in my head, and I'm like going, well, at the beginning, it looked like it was going to be cool because he was in Surtur's place, and then Surtur had a wimpy voice, and he wasn't menacing, and there was a fight there. It wasn't very compelling. Thor did his thing. He spun his hammer, some lightning. It was nothing too incredible. And then the Doctor Strange cameo comes in, and it was all strange right there. I guess that's why they had Doctor Strange in there. But it was such a small, minute part. And it was only they had to find a way to connect Odin into this. And here's Odin, this old guy dying off or something in this other realm, this other place on Earth. Sitting there in a little I think it was like a corduroy jacket. I'm not sure exactly. He's just sitting there staring off into the ocean, and then he just kind of fades away. I mean, they really didn't know what to do with any of the characters. And I'd been commenting on videos over the past few weeks that I was really, really worried that this movie was going to be all hype and there was going to be nothing good about it. And I was trying to give it a chance. And right from the get-go, right from the very beginning, I didn't like it. And as it progressed through, it got a little bit better. I'm like, okay, maybe it's improving a little bit. And then it would take another crap, and then another crap, and then another crap. Till finally, by the end of the movie, you were left with a plate of turd the size of the theater. And I'm hoping, at this point, that they find a way to get rid of Thor. So we don't have to deal with Thor anymore. Because they've ruined the Thor character. All three movies were at the bottom of the food chain when it comes to the MCU saga of this whole Infinity War and all the characters and the culmination of this universe. Thor, all three of the movies are at the bottom of the heap. And this last Thor movie, Thor Ragnarok, is a piece of turd. I'm telling you, don't go see this movie. Don't even waste your time. It barely connects anything in to the Infinity Saga. In fact, you don't need it. You do not need it, as far as I can tell. It does not matter. And guess what? The Soul Stone was not there. Spoiler alert, no Soul Stone, so it's got to be in Black Panther. That's a big spoiler. Now, I'm sorry, I might be ruining it for some people. And a lot of you people had your hopes up, but I'm telling you, it's not worth going to. And if a bunch of people are going to go see this movie, it's going to keep giving Marvel the idea that these crappy pieces of junk they can put together for us, slap them together, and throw them out, and everybody's going to go to them. We want epic movies, Mr. Feige. We want epic movies like Captain America Winter Soldier, like the first Avenger movie, like the Spider-Man movie. You just did it. You just had a great movie, probably one of the top five movies you guys have produced out of the Marvel Studios. Spider-Man Homecoming, you just did it. Then you come back the next one with maybe the worst of the bunch in Thor Ragnarok. Not only am I disappointed as a huge Thor fan that Marvel and their infinite wisdom have ruined the character of Thor. Not only have they taken away this thought that Thor was a little more cultured than the rest of the Avengers and he had, he was a higher power. They've dumbed him down. They made him like an idiot. He's just a stupid idiot now. And I hope that they find a way to keep Chris Evans in the MCU and just drop Thor at this point. Because either Chris Hemsworth is a worthless actor, which I'm starting to believe, or Marvel can't come up with a decent Thor movie where it makes sense all the way through and they don't have to make you stretch to believe something. You know those parts in The Dark World that Jane Foster was flipping the little button and dimension was shifting and the bad guys be over here and then over here and then, you know, we thought that was bad, right? This movie is filled with those kind of things. And the humor, as I was saying earlier, the humor is so bad in this movie. It's childish. It's not well thought out. And in fact, most of it looks improv'd. These are not lines that they thought out in advance. I think they threw this together. They were like, well, we got to end the Thor saga somehow. We got to get rid of it. He's got another movie under his contract for Thor. We've got nothing. And it's amazing they had nothing because Surtur, who was one of the big highlights, I thought, oh man, they're showing off Surtur. One was Hulk's fighting Surtur, and the other one Thor's fighting Surtur. Surtur was hardly part of the story. A little bit at the beginning, a little bit at the end. Nothing much to do about anything. Hela, even though she was the main bad guy of the movie, was hardly a bad guy. I mean, she was bad and evil, and you knew she was bad and evil. But that was it. There was hardly any dialogue between Hela and Thor. The motivation for her versus what Thor's motivation was okay, but it wasn't solid. You didn't get into this character. I mean, again, you go back to Spider-Man Homecoming. Not only did you side with Peter Parker, not only did you side with Tony Stark about how Peter Parker was acting, but you sided with the Vulture. You understood the character. You knew his motivations. You even felt for the guy. And there was twists in there, and it was a well-put-together movie. And here you got Thor Ragnarok. A movie which, by all accounts, story-wise, is definitely the worst story they've written yet. Now, if you want to get caught up in all the CGI, all the graphics, all that, sure, that stuff's great. Looks like Guardians of the Galaxy. I didn't like that movie either. I didn't even see the second one because I hated the first one. Now, if you're into simple humor, childish humor, then you might like the movie. If you don't care about storylines, if you don't care about continuity, then you might like the humor. If you don't mind them dragging it out to where nothing makes sense, then fine. You're probably going to like the movie on just the visuals. But if you're a guy like me and who understands continuity, who expects the continuity to continue, not only with the characters in their development, which this movie was so far gone from any of the Thor movies as far as how Thor acted. All the Thor movies, all the Avenger movies is far gone. Not even close to a good movie. And Thor didn't even... he wasn't even Thor. You know, the way we knew him. You see, he's had four movies to develop. And all of a sudden, he's something different. And I can tell you, this Thor is terrible. The Hulk. Oh, my God. The Hulk. I hope that they fix the Hulk in Infinity War. Because not only did the Hulk not look very good, the CGI was, you know, it was okay. But the dialogue was terrible. He wasn't funny. And I don't like this new direction the Hulk's going into. Highlights. Cate Blanchett, the very small part she had. Valkyrie was all right, even though they changed that character up from the comic books. The Game Master, it's just Jeff Goldblum, dude. You like Jeff Goldblum? You like the way he acts every movie? You're not going to see anything wrong with it. And Scourge, to be honest with you, that wasn't a good character either. They had a chance to put one of their best movies together with some of the best cast they ever had. And they flushed it all down the toilet with a piece of crap. I'm not even going to tell you how the Warriors 3 end up. Unbelievable. Anyways, I think I've gone on long enough. I suggest you don't go see Thor Ragnarok. Wait till it comes out on video if you need to catch the story. In my humble opinion, it has nothing at all to... do with the Infinity Saga that's coming up. The Infinity War doesn't relate in any way. You see the Tesseract for a minute. And maybe Hela's there for the death connection with Thanos. But that's as close as you get to any Thor Ragnarok. In fact, from the promotion, they were kind of lying to us on what was going on with Thor Ragnarok. It's all hype. Not a good movie. Save your money. Don't go to the theaters. Watch it when it comes out on DVD. Hopefully Black Panther will be much better. It looks better. We're just hoping it's going to be better. And let me know what you think if you've seen it in the comment section below. Tell me what you think. Of course, my normal listeners, my normal subscribers know I don't normally do this kind of stuff. I do other things. So if you're new to the channel, subscribe us, like us, follow us a little bit here, and see if you don't mind some of the other content we're doing. Everybody who's been following me, hey, just give me a break on this one. I'm trying to save everybody a few bucks from getting ripped off from seeing this movie. Thanks a lot, folks. Hopefully we'll talk to you soon. And let me know what you think in the comment section below.